In the name of Assembly Member Barry, whilst you introduce the motion, there's also an amendment, as you know. If you can indicate if you are content to accept the amendment or not. So, Assembly Member Barry, it's over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. I'll start by introducing my motion. I'd like to thank, first of all, my Assembly Member colleague, Andrew Boff, for seconding the motion and introduce this important topic. It's been very common to see in the news talk of a lost generation, children, young people who haven't been able to attend lessons, aspiring students who didn't get to go to university or have gone there and been isolated by from friends and family. These are forever lost milestones of growing up and taking your place in the world. We've been rightly concerned about the effects of the pandemic on the young, their well-being and on their futures. And we've seen parents and teachers across the city making heroic efforts to get our young back into schools and universities. And it's only right that we act in a similar manner for the most vulnerable under 25s. We need to make sure that homeless people get the specialist support they need to make it through the tough winter ahead. Now, I commend the Mayor for securing tens of millions of pounds in new funding and for going the extra mile to make sure homeless Londoners are protected from the cold this winter, and the work that they've been doing in the GLA to bring people into hotels as well. And we now need to push on and make sure that these services work the best they possibly can. And I mean push on and set aside funds within these budgets for suitable accommodation for under 25s. What we've seen is the number of young people living on the streets rising by 47% this year in the last quarter compared with the same time last year. They're now 11% of our city's homeless people. And although I believe there are some dedicated beds dotted around the hotel scheme in the Mayor's programmes, along with some dedicated youth support, this simply doesn't match the 368 young people who have been made homeless between July and September alone this year, and this number grows all the time. So we do need more dedicated space. Even more concerning are the real stories behind these statistics. I've met with youth workers from homeless charities for young people, heard from the badly affected boroughs, and there you've got outreach workers saying there are young people bedding down in parks for the first time. Informal support, the kind of friends and family who put them up, that's become impossible in the pandemic. And this is the first time a lot of these young people have been made homeless and left with nowhere to turn. The research I've carried out via YouGov found thousands and thousands of Londoners who would normally do their bit to put somebody up, a friend or a friend of a friend or a friend of their children who would need help. They would normally put them up on sofas and spare rooms. They've had to close their doors because of the pandemic rules. So yes, winter's going to be uniquely hard. Young people are facing the prospect of sleeping on the streets in higher numbers than we've seen in many years. And by definition, these young people are facing this kind of trauma for the first time. Homelessness has not yet damaged them, but we do know that being without a home is a key adverse experience that does damage people for life. And we can prevent this damage, mitigate it with the right kind of help and the right dedicated services, such as keeping the young people together in accommodation rather than with more experienced rough sleepers, with dedicated support attached from youth and social workers. And I think this is a response rightly provided at a pan-London level. We've heard in the Housing Committee this from boroughs responsible too. That's why this motion calls on the Mayor to lead on this, take targeted action with his own budgets by ring-fencing space and the right proportion of funds for dedicated support for homeless under 25s in London. We know that prevention at the right time is far better than dealing with problems later. I urge you to support this motion. Now, on the amendment we've received from Labour, essentially, I'm happy to accept this. What it does is it adds in some news that's come in since the motion was written, which is that the Mayor's Rough Sleeping campaign this winter is specifically raising funds for youth homelessness charities who are doing their best to help as well. That's a good thing. And then it says at the end, it adds the phrase, and calls on the government to provide additional funding to support this. This is good. It's an and, it's not a but. What it isn't doing is removing the crux of the matter from this motion, which is that the mayor should be providing dedicated ring-fence spaces for under 25s. That's the real point of this motion, and that still rings out clearly from the amended draft. So I'm happy to accept the amendment as well.